Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So today we'll start our new lesson and the name of our lesson is Variety in Food. This lesson you will get in State Board Fourth Standard textbook. Okay, so let's start for the lesson. Again I will repeat the name of the lesson. The name of the lesson is what? Variety in Food. In the name only you can understand what we are going to discuss in the lesson. Variety means what? There are the different types of the food items we are adding in our diet, or every day we are having a different types of the food items in our meal. Okay, so if I ask the question, what do you have in the breakfast? So you will give me the answer that we have idli, dosa, we have poha, rava. Okay, so all this way there are the different food items that we are having in our daily life. Okay, but there is not a single food item that we are having every day. Every day we are having the certain types of the different food items. But in that also, there are the certain foodstuff, there are the certain food material that we are adding in our meal, or that is the part of our meal every day. Okay, so let's discuss about that. So we have said that there are the certain food material, food stuff that we are having every day. Okay, so if we talk about the rice, okay, then rice is the basic food item in our meal. Every day we are having the rice. Okay, so with the help of the rice we can make the different food stuffs or different food items. Okay, so the rice is the basic ingredients, we can say that, or what we can say that various dishes can be made from same ingredients. Okay, the various dishes can be made from the same ingredients. Here we'll take the one example of the rice. So the rice is our basic ingredients, and from that basic ingredients we can make the different food materials or food items. Okay, so let's see, if we'll write here rice, then with the help of the rice we can make the so many different things. We can make the idlis, we can make the dosa, we can make the modak, we can make bhakri. Okay, so for making of this idli, dosa, bhakri, rice, what we need, what is our basic ingredients? That is nothing but what? Rice. Okay, so the rice is single ingredients. From that single ingredients we can make the different types of the food items or the food materials. Okay, so what we have discussed here, the various dishes can be made from same ingredients. Okay, so the different food dish we can make with the help of the same ingredients. Okay, and what is meant by the ingredients? These are the substances by using that we are making the different food materials. Okay, next one, even when there is a variety in the dishes, the basic ingredients remains the same. Okay, so even there is a variety in the different dish, we can say that idli is there, then we can say that idli is there, dosa is there, rice is there, different types of the rice is there, modak is there, bhakri is there, which is also made from the rice flour. Okay, so these are the different food dish. Okay, to make that different food dish, what we are using? The same ingredients, that is nothing but what? Rice. Okay, so there is a variety in that dish, but to make that food, the main product or the basic ingredients remains what? Same. Here we have taken the example of rice. Okay, so the rice, we can say the basic ingredients, and from that basic ingredients we can make the different food materials. Okay, so in short what we can say, that from single food material or single ingredients we can make the different types of the food stuff. Okay, or the different types of the food items we can make from the single ingredients. Okay, next one, there is diversity in the food items of the different states of our country. Okay, so as we know, our India is a very beautiful country and very big country also. There are the so many states are present in our country, and each and every states is having different type of the food, or there is a special food for each and every states. Okay, so if we'll talk about the Maharashtra, in our Maharashtra there are the so many food materials are there which are very famous for the Maharashtra. So we'll talk about the Maharashtra, then the first things come in our mind, that is nothing but what? Vada pav. Okay, so the vada pav, we can say the famous for the Maharashtra. Also we can say the modak is there, puran poli is there. Okay, so all these food material is famous for the Maharashtra. So if we'll talk about the other states, for example, we can say that Gujarat, then there is a dhokla is famous, thepla is there, okay, khakra is there. So all these food items we can see in the Gujarat. So why I'm telling that? Because according to the states, the food items or the food stuffs get changed. There is a diversity in the food items according to the states, okay. But why there is a diversity in the food, why there is a big variety in the food items according to the states? Because as we know, our India is a very big country, yeah, and in that country, according to the states, the climatic condition is also get changed, okay. So if we'll talk about the north region, in the north region there is extremely cold, okay, during the winter. If we'll talk about the south region, then there is a very beautiful in the south region there is a very hot and humid climate, we can say that. If we'll talk about the Rajasthan, then as we know, in the Rajasthan there is extremely hot climatic condition. And if we'll talk about the eastern part of the India, then there is a very beautiful rainfall, okay. So in this way, there is a different climatic condition is present in throughout the year in the different parts of the India. And according to that different parts or according to that different climatic conditions, the different states is taking the different types of the crops, okay. And because of the different types of the crops, the food material that they are making are also different, okay. So that is what there is diversity. Diversity means what? Variety. There are so many different food materials present in each and every state, okay. There is diversity in the food item of the different states of our country, okay. So this we have discussed that why there is having different food variety in the every country because of the different types of the climatic conditions, okay. So next one, we are getting these different crops, okay. So if we'll talk about the crops, the first things comes in our mind, that is nothing but what? Agriculture, okay. So what is mean by agriculture? So if we'll talk about our India, then our India is a agriculture based country, okay. The most of the people occupation is nothing but what? Agriculture, okay. The 70% of the people is performing the or their occupation is what? Agriculture, okay. And we all are directly or indirectly depends on the agriculture for our food, okay. So let's discuss what is mean by agriculture, okay. Let's see the mass production of plants for food and other purposes is called agriculture, okay. What is mean by agriculture? The mass production means what? Large, the plenty of the production. For which purpose? For the food purpose and for the other purposes, okay. Like that some animals also we are rearing with us, from animals also we are getting the different types of the food materials, in that we can say. So it also comes in the agriculture, okay. So here we are taking the crops for the food, also some crops we are using for the clothes, like that we can say the cotton is used for making the clothes, okay. Or we can say the oil seeds are there, then that oil seeds we are using for the taking or to take the oil from that oil seeds, okay. So in this way, different crops we can use for foods and for the other purposes, okay. So once again I will repeat the definition. The mass production of plants for food and other purposes is called agriculture, okay. So it's called the agriculture. The India is basically the agriculture based country, okay. And as you were previously we have discussed that in India there is a rainfall, but in all the parts there is not same rainfall. In some region there is a heavy rainfall, in the some region there is a extremely low rainfall, or in the some region there is a moderate rainfall, okay. Moderate means what? Not more also, not less also. Medium type of the rainfall is there, okay. So according to the rainfall we can get, or the people in that state can get, or people in that regions are taking the different crops, okay. So see, if we talk about our Konkan region, okay, we are generally related to the coastal area and we are having the more amount of a rainfall. So now you can see in our surrounding there are the different types of the crops, but among all these crops we can see, if we'll observe properly, then what is our conclusion, or what we can observe, that there there is a more amount of rice crop. Okay, rice crop means what? It is also called as paddy crops. Okay, so why there is a rice crop of the paddy crops? We can see in the more number, because in our Konkan region the rainfall is more and the paddy crops requires the more amount of rainfall. So that is the reason the farmers are preferred to take the paddy crops or the rice crops. Okay, so according to the regions the crops is also getting changes. Why? Because there is a different climatic condition, different amount of the rainfall is there, humidity is there and temperature is also different, and all these temperature, humidity and the rainfall plays a vital role in the growth of plants or in the growth of crops. Okay, so let's discuss according to the types of the rainfall, which plants are cultivated in the different regions. First we'll talk about the high rainfall. High rainfall means what? Usually there is raining in a lot of amount. Okay, so in the region of the high rainfall the farmers are preferring or they are cultivated the crops like rice, coconut, ragi and varai. Okay, so these are the crops that they are cultivated in the high rainfall region. And if we'll talk about the moderate rainfall means what? The medium condition of the rainfall, not maximum also and not minimum also, in this way. Okay, moderate rainfall. And in that moderate rainfall, which crops are cultivated? The crops like wheat, tur and soyabean. Okay, these crops are mostly cultivated in the moderate rainfall. Next one, that is low rainfall. Low rainfall means what? We can say that there is a scarcity of the water, there is a very less rainfall happens in the certain region, and in that region the crops are cultivated like jowar, bajra and moth beans. Okay, these crops are cultivated in the low rainfall region. Okay, so see here from these what we can understand. So according to the different regions, the rainfall amount is different. There is a difference in the rainfall, temperature and humidity, and it also affects the different types of the crops, and that's why we are taking the different types of the crops in the different regions. Okay, so this is, we have talked about the crops. Now the next one we'll discuss about the seasonal fruits. Okay, now seasonal fruits means what? Those we are getting usually in the different seasons. Okay, so just now we have enjoyed the summer season. Okay, and if we'll talk about the summer season, then the first things comes in your mind, that is what? Yes, you are correct, that is what? Mango. Okay, so we are getting the mango only in the summer season, and that is means what? The mango is a seasonal fruit. So if we decide that I want to eat the mango in a winter season, then is it possible? No, then you will not get the fresh mango in a winter season. You will get the fresh mango only in a summer season. Okay, so it means what? The mango is a seasonal fruit. Okay, that we are getting in a summer season. If we'll talk about the winter, then in winter basically we are getting the oranges or we are getting the grapes. Okay, and during the rainy season we are getting the different types of the apples, we can say bananas, we can say. Okay, so mostly all these different fruits we are getting in a different seasons. Okay, so in this way the seasonal fruits we are getting or we are enjoying for that particular seasons. Okay, but nowadays because of the technology, what we can say that the seasonal fruits we can enjoy throughout the year because of the different food preserving practices that we have already seen. Okay, and also one more thing, the certain types of the fruits which are not cultivated in our region, that fruits also we can enjoy in our region because of the fast transportations. Okay, so because of the transportation we can transport the different fruits from the different regions, from the different states, and we can enjoy in our that fruits in our regions. Okay, so in this way we can take this seasonal fruit or we can enjoy these seasonal fruits for that particular seasons. Okay, okay, so let's see the next point, that is crops grown in a region determine the diet of the people in that region. Okay, so what this sentence tells us? That
crops grown in a region determine the diet of the people in that region. It means what? As we have discussed before, in the different regions we are cultivated the different types of the crops. Okay, so if we talk about the Konkan, in the Konkan region we are taking the more amount of the rice crops. Okay, and that is the reason most of the people, those who are living in the Konkan region, their diet includes the food items which are made from the rice. Okay, so we can say that they are making the different types of the food dish with the rice. We can say that idli is there, they can make the modak, or they are preparing the bhakri which is made from the rice. Okay, also we can say in the coastal region there is a more number of there is a big number of coconut trees. Okay, so from that coconuts they are using that coconut more amount in their food material, or also they are removing the coconut oil from that coconuts and they are using that coconut oil in their food stuffs. Okay, so according to the region there are the different crops, and that different crops makes the staple food for the people, those who are living in that region. Okay, so the crops grown in a region determine the diet. Okay, determine the diet of the people in that regions. Okay, so in the Konkan region the basically the diet comes, or the diet materials, the diet things which includes, that is what? Rice. Okay, the rice is the main diet product or the food material in the Konkan region. Okay, and if we'll talk about the central Maharashtra, then in the central Maharashtra jowar, bajra, groundnut and soya beans are getting cultivated. So the mostly peoples are using these crops, and from this food or from these crops they are making the different types of the food dish and they are including in their diets. Okay, so according to the region there are the different types of the crops, and according to the crops the people is having their diets. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the variety in food. In that we have discussed the different points. I hope you have understood all these points. So here it is the time to tell you goodbye. I'll see you in the next video for today. Thank you.